What's up, guys? This is Bathroom, Shower, and Tile Ideas, Episode 2. Let's take a quick look at the before and after photos, and then we'll do a quick walkthrough on the material used for this build. What's up, guys? We'll start with the floor. Again, it's the same floor in episode one. It's a 12-inch by 24-inch rectified porcelain. Now, being rectified allows us to give a true 16-inch grout line. So the floor is staggered again at 50% and is absolutely flat using the Raimondi tile leveling clips and system. So that turned out great. We've got a vanity here. Now, this vanity is interesting. This was an old cabinet laying around. The customer decided to sand it, stain it. What we did was simple. Bore a couple of holes for the drain kit as well as the faucet and water lines, and basically do a little modification within the drawers to accept the plumbing. But yeah, this turned out great. So if you have any old furniture laying around, you know, it could be used for bathroom or home remodels. So we think it turned out. All right, guys, here's the shower. Turned out great again. Like episode one, we used a 4-inch by 16-inch ceramic, installed it vertically with a straight pattern, turned out great, nice flat walls. We used an RLS tile leveling system on this entire shower. We've got a nice feature wall back here, an accent wall. This turned out great, porcelain planks. Very durable, low maintenance. You've got the ceramic 4-inch by 16-inch over here. Nice symmetrical niche, as you can see. Tile in the center. Again, we use the quarter round Schluter PVC tile edging. Very subtle, very low profile look. Again, use the trim here. Very subtle, very low profile. Turned out great. Again, the pan is travertine, your travertine sheets. That looks great. We use a solid surface for the curb. It's always good to use solid surface for the curb or your bench top just to avoid grout lines. It's much easier for maintenance, and we think it gives it a much cleaner look. So there you guys have it, episode 2. Tell us in the comments what you like about it, what you don't like about it, and stay tuned for episode 3 in about a week and a half. Thanks for watching, guys.